Good morning, class 12th. So welcome here again for our English core class. So let's continue the chapter which we have started from the last spring, the story of Mukesh, who was the bangle maker and who used to live in the area called Firozabad. So let's try to complete the reading here. So we need to understand what basically happened next when he met Anisha. So we need to start from here. The cry of not having money to do anything except carry on the business of making bangles, not even enough to eat, rings in every home. The young man echoed the lament of their elders. Little has moved with time, it seems, in Firozabad. Years of mind-numbing toil have killed all initiative and the ability to dream. So basically it talks about that the people, those who are living in that area, those who are bangle makers, they were crying that from a longer period of time, their families are indulged in this profession only, right? So they were crying because they are having no money in their hand. They were just doing the business of making bangles. They are not even having enough food to eat. So the young man echoed the lament of their elders. So lament here means complaint. Young men always complained of their elders because they have learned that thing from their parents, from their elders only. So with the passage of time, nothing much has changed. Years of mind numbing, that is the boring, toil, the physical activities and the profession, what they were doing. So from many years, they have been doing this work only, and basically the initiative or to think about themselves or the ability to dream, which was killed because they were busy in just earning the money while indulging themselves into that profession. Next is, why not organize yourselves into a cooperative? This is a very, very important one. Why not organize yourselves into cooperative? So Anisha wanted to know that why don't you come together, why don't you make some cooperative one, why don't you complain about this, that you people are facing the number of challenges. I asked a group of young men who has fallen into the vicious circle of middlemen who trapped their fathers and forefathers. So vicious circle means where you have been trapped, you can't come out from that situation. Like a web only, a web of poverty we can say, a web where you are just going inside and inside only, you are not able to come out. So they were trapped into that circle of middlemen, their fathers and forefathers. They tried, but unfortunately nobody came out. Even if we get organized, we are the ones who will be hauled up by the police, beaten and dragged to jail for doing something illegal. So he said that if by chance we try to organize themselves, if we will go to the police to complain about it or to make a cooperative, we would be the only one who would be taken to the jail. The police people, the policemen, they will beat us, they will drag us to the jail, and they said that you are doing something illegal because of your own choice. There is no leader among them, no one who could help them see things differently. So nobody was there with those bangle makers who can help them out. Their fathers are as tired as they are. So it means from a long years, everyone was tied up. They talk endlessly in a spiral that moves from poverty to apathy to greed and to injustice. So like in the spiral, you have seen that how it revolves, right? So in the same manner, from a longer period of time, from many years, they were just trapped into that one only. So I guess till here it's clear to you. Okay, next it says, listening to them, I see two distinct worlds. Now, important to underline, one of the family caught in a web of poverty. So means those people, those bangle makers were trapped into two things. One, they were already in poverty. And second, by the stigma of caste in which they are born. That is the first one, the poor one. And the others, a vicious circle of these sahukars, middlemen, policemen, keepers of law, bureaucrats and the politicians. Means already once, they are into that poor strata. Secondly, they are into the circle of these powerful, influential people, those who would not help them at all. Together, they have imposed a baggage on the child that he cannot put down. So all these people came together, they have put in a burden on the child and they can't do anything. Before he is aware, he accepts it as naturally as his father. So means when a person is a child, so he or she does not know what is right or wrong. So he just so that burden has been given to them, and they try to started following that, and later on when they get aware, they can't do anything because they have already habitual. To do anything else would mean dear. So means they can't think about something else. It would be like a dear for them. And daring is not part of his growing up. When I sense a flash of it in Mukesh, I'm cheered. I want to be a motor mechanic, he repeats. See, he will go to a garage and learn, but the garage is a long way from his home. I will walk, he insists. Do you also dream of flying a plane? So he said that I am going to learn, no problem. I will learn how to drive. I would learn everything at the garage. So Nizanga, do you also dream of flying a plane? So he said no, while looking at the ground, because he murmured. He said very slowly, in the embarrassment, that there is an embarrassment that has not yet turned into regret. He is content, means happy, to dream of cars that he sees hurtling down the street of his town. Few airplanes fly over Firozabad. So he had no dream of flying the plane. He was the grounded person. He just wanted to be with the cars only. Few airplanes only have seen in his life. So he was not interested. He was more interested to drive a car, to be a motor mechanic. So I hope it's clear to you. So there's a question, what makes the city of Firozabad famous? You can mention about bangles. Mention the hazards of working. I have already discussed. How is Mukesh's attitude to his situation different from that of his family? He wanted to be a motor mechanic. He wanted to come out from that situation. But unfortunately, family has accepted. It is his karma and destiny that you need to decide. So other things we can discuss in the next class. So I really hope it's clear. If you are having still any doubt, please raise, clear it out. Do the work timely and send the worksheet to me timely to you. God bless you. Thank you so much.